Hello, my name's Cody Briggs. I'm a saddle maker at Big Ben Saddlery. In this month's tack tip, we're going to be talking about mule hide horn wraps. We're going to start the video off. We're going to explain a little bit about what they are and what to look for when buying them. And then in the end of the video, we're going to show you how to install one. When shopping for a horn wrap, one thing that you want to be sure and look for is to make sure that the horn wrap has that slick side on it, or that's the side that the hair grows out of it. That's also where all the strength is, and if it doesn't have a hair side, it's probably not going to last very long. Another thing you want to be sure and check out is make sure it's plenty long. This one here is about 7 foot long. That way you can get two horn wraps out of it. And also, you just kind of want to run your hand down there. Just check for see if there's any butcher cuts or anything that's going to create a weak spot in it. That's definitely going to lead to premature wear. The reason for a horn wrap is to prevent damage from the neck of your horn. If your rope burns a hole in your horn cover there, that could cost up to a couple hundred dollars to fix. Or you could just have a mule hide horn wrap for under $25 and you could prevent all that damage from happening. Alright, now I'm going to show you how we wrap a horn. First, I'm going to take this, just any end, just slide it underneath the gullet. And then we're just going to put it up in front of the horn like that. We're just kind of getting a guess length of what it needs to be. Then just come it across. Just start wrapping it. And if you're a right-handed roper, you're going to wrap them around the horn clockwise. And then left, you're going to go counterclockwise. And we're just going to kind of take a few loose wraps on it. Get it up over the top there. Just figure that's about how long we're going to need it, and we'll just go just a little bit longer just to make sure. Now I'm going to take that over here to my bench. Now I'm just going to cut the tail, just a nice little angled cut like that, and come back and do another. Now on this other end that's going to go around the horn, I just like to trim the edges off just like that, just a little less bulk that way. Now I'm going to take this punch here, and we're going to drive it right through the end. And this is what's going to go around the neck of the horn. But one thing I did forget to mention earlier is you're going to want to soak this in water, and you're going to want it to soak through pretty good, and then you're probably going to take it out and let it air dry for an hour in the shade. If you leave it in the sun, it'll be a lot quicker than that. But what we're going to do is we're going to figure out how far we need to cut this down to put it over the cap of the horn. And you just kind of eyeball it and figure we'll just go for right there. And you're going to make two cuts, and you're going to end up on each end of that circle, or each side of the circle. So you kind of have a V cut into the circle like that. And then we're going to slide that over the cap of the horn. Tuck it back underneath through your hand holder. Go underneath the gullet. Come back on the off side of your horn. And we're going to start wrapping it. And what you're going to, as soon as you start turning it around, you're going to work towards the top of the horn. The end goal is to kind of have your horn coming down at a slant like this. That way your rope's going to run down to the base of the horn. And you're going to want to pull it fairly tight. But we'll finish her off later on tightening it down. And then once you get up to the top of the horn, we're going to start working our way back down. And when you make this final wrap, you're going to want your horn wrap to kind of lay on your swells like little angle here, so that way your rope can't get underneath of it and burn up your swell cover. Alright, we got her around there. Now you just need to get something and get under here. You're going to get under this part and just lift that up. and slide that through there. And then tighten that down. There's other ways to put these on that involve driving tacks on the bottom side of the gullet. But doing that way, the problem is that you're gonna, if you start running some, if this gets some slack in it, it has nowhere to go. There's nowhere for it to escape. But doing one like this, you can just keep pulling the slack out and it just stays, gets tighter and tighter. And how we put these on there, we have a strap here. It's just an old Latigo that we doubled over and stitched and put a hole in the end here. Just get it wet, dunk her in the tub. And I take my hammer handle and get it going around your horn like that. Then just work it around. You shouldn't have to have a whole lot of pressure. It should just slide pretty easy. And all you're doing is taking the slack out of that wrap and tightening it up. And you can do the same thing I'm doing now with a rope. Just tie it off on a fence post or something stuck in the ground pretty good and dally around and just walk off. And that kind of has the same effect to it. That's what we're doing right now. All right. Now you got that. Just pull that slack out of there and that's ready to go. Thank you for watching. If you have any other questions about this video or any others, or if you have any suggestions of videos you'd like to see, just give us a call. Thank you.